So a couple of weeks ago, I asked you guys on Instagram, what videos should I make? And the two top requests were a Lightroom editing video, which you're gonna see now, and a review of the Lova 25mm f2.8 2.5 to 5x super or ultra macro lens. And that one is coming as well. I'm just waiting for the lens. So in this video, I'm just gonna show you some general editing, how I edit photos, and I've included here a mix of both macro photos and normal photos. And these are photos that I've already edited in the past and published in on Instagram and so on, but now I'm gonna go from the raw files and redo the edits of them, and in some cases they might become a lot different than the ones I've already published. But yeah, so let's start with this one. So the first thing I usually look at when I edit a photo is if the exposure is right, like if the picture is the right amount of light, and here or bright. And here I would say that the exposure is pretty good as it is from the beginning. And after that, I usually check, like, do I want to do something about the framing? And in this case, no, I don't think I want to do that. But one thing I do see that kind of bothers me from the first second that I looked at this image is that the white balance is completely off. And this is something a lot of beginners don't really think about, but that can really make a huge difference in a photo if the white balance is correct or not. And even with today's modern cameras, the white balance often becomes a little bit off. And the good thing though is that it is very easy to correct in Lightroom. What I usually do, since I'm lazy, is that I use the white balance picker here. And then you just need to point it somewhere that has a nuance of white or gray, preferably gray, that is like true gray. Gray that has no hints of blue or yellow or anything in it. And in this case, I know that, for example, this door here is white. And if I point there, the white balance should be pretty correct. What you also need to think about when you use this white balance picker is that you need to pick somewhere where the main light source that shines on your subject also shines. So it's even better if I pick here. Now it didn't do a big difference, but sometimes if you use the picker on something in the background, the white balance will still be off because there was a different light source shining in the background. Anyways, now the white balance is correct. What I see now when I look at the picture is that it looks pretty good already. I'm pretty happy with it, but what I would like to do is to increase the shadows a bit, because his eyes are a little bit dark and the inside of this cap is a little bit dark. I don't see any details there. And now we have a difference. The eyes are shining a bit more and they look a bit better, and you can see a little bit of the details on the inside of the cap, which I think is nice. And now I'm pretty happy with this photo, and one thing I would like to try is to play around with the whites a little. You can make it look even brighter. Would like to increase them a little bit. And then since the picture is already very bright, that's kind of the key feature of this photo, maybe I want to increase that a little bit more. And you could do that with some white vignetting, like some soft white vignetting like this, or maybe that was a little bit too much, like this. And now I'm happy with this photo. I think it's a good photo, and now with this edit I'm happy with it. Let's go move on to the next one. So here we have a ladybug, and as I said, the first thing I look at usually is the exposure, and this one is a bit too dark. Let's make it a little bit brighter. And what I see now is that, oh, this highlight here is a little bit bothering. It was because I used a flash diffuser that wasn't big enough, or maybe the flash was a little bit too strong. Let's try to soften it by weakening the highlights. Worked pretty well. And I also see that the background is pretty damn dark. I would like to see a little bit more color from the background. So let's lift the shadows. And yeah, we can bring out a little bit more green here from the background. And I would also like to see if the white balance is good. Here we don't have like an obvious point to use the picker. Maybe we could use the picker here. Actually, that looked pretty good. I think I'm gonna go with that. Like sometimes the background became a little bit greener, and it might not be like the correct white balance, but it made the photo look better, and that makes me happy about the change. What I like to do often in macro photos as well is to fine tune the nuance of the key colors in the photo. So here maybe we could make this the shell of the ladybug a little bit like redder. Let's see, without making it look like weird. Yeah, I don't want to do too much here. And also I would like to see the greens, if we can adjust them in some way. No, this looks too unnatural. I want the picture to look interesting, but not unnatural. I'm heightening the hue a little bit here, and let's see about the saturation. Yeah, let's increase it a little bit. Otherwise, it becomes too much. I like colorful photos. This is, of course, like a personal preference, but yeah, that's my style. And what I very often like to do in portraits and in the macro photos of an insect is to add some vignetting. Vignetting almost always make the picture look better, according to me. It kind of creates an ambiance, it frames the subject and makes the subject pop out a bit more. Yeah, but not too heavy. I think this is the right amount for this photo. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with this. Let me just play around a little bit with the blacks. Yeah, so that the black parts are really black. That's nice. Yeah, let's move on. I'm happy with that photo. This one, the first thing I'm thinking here is that it is too dark, and especially this fly. It's like, yeah, you don't see any details at all in it. So let's make the photo hell of a lot brighter. Still don't see that many details here. Let's lift the shadows. Yeah, now we see a bit more of the insect. But at the same time, when I lifted everything in the photo, the colors are a bit bleak. Let's play around with the vibrance and the saturation. Oh, now it became like too much. Let's see. Yeah, it's a fine balance. Maybe I can use this tool here to make the greens a bit greener. Lowering the luminance a little bit and making them a bit greener. I think I like this. I'm thinking about the framing. What I don't really like about the crop here is that the fly is like almost completely in the middle, and usually that kind of framing is not great, if you ask me. I think I would like to shorten the photo a bit on this side, so that we kind of use the rule of thirds a little bit here. I think this gives a bit of a better balance to the photo. And also, similar to this photo, maybe we can play on the strength of this photo, that it is very bright, by, let me just, yeah, I'm gonna draw out the whites here, just to make, like, if you want the highlights, or the like really bright highlights of your photo to really shine, heightening the whites like this is a really good thing to do, and I think actually it improves the photo. And what I was going to say was that, like we did in this photo, we could also try adding a little bit of white vignetting to see how that plays out. Okay, let's just add a little. I'm not sure if that was better or not. Yeah, okay, just a little, like that. now it's, I think it's good. Now it's starting to become something I like, this photo. Let's not touch the blacks. Let's play around with the highlights a bit. Actually, I like the look when you increase the highlights a little bit, like this. I like the very bright, colorful look that we get now in the photo. This thing in the background here, I don't really like that it's sticking up towards the edge of the frame. Let's try to cut this off a little bit. Oh, that was the wrong tool for that. Or maybe we just need more feather. Okay, that's good. Yeah, I like this better. Yeah, I'm happy with that photo. Let's move on. Yeah, it's quite obvious what we want to do here. make it brighter. Yeah, I like to bring out a bit of details in the leaf as well. Now the ladybug is visible. The background though is a bit overexposed. Let's try to counter that if possible. It wasn't really possible, but I still think this picture looks pretty good. One thing I'm gonna try is to try to remove this part and see if it's an improvement or not. No. Now I think the photo looks a bit too minimalistic. Let's keep that, but let's lift the shadows a bit, a slight bit, like that. What else can we do? Actually, I kind of like how the ladybug is just a small part and that the leaf is a pretty big part of the subject of this photo. I don't think we can do much cropping here that would improve it. Possibly, if we go in from the left, let's try that. I think actually this improved the photo. It was like, I liked it before as well, but somehow this created a kind of yin and yang balance between these two parts of the photo, which are like the only parts where you actually rest your eyes. Let's try playing with the blacks a bit. Vibrance. No, it's easily becomes too much green. I'm just gonna see what I can do about the orange color on the ladybug. Maybe a little bit like that. And let's also see what we can do with the greens. No, I want them to look natural. I like this. Still, the ladybug feels a little bit too dark. Can we lower the contrast? No. Oh, it seems like it is kind of hard to fix that. Yeah, we lift the shadows a bit and it becomes a bit brighter. Yeah, now I think I'm pretty... Yeah, let's not touch the contrast. Now I'm pretty happy with this photo. Let's move on. This is one of my favorite shots from last year. Venus Optics actually even used it in their stand at Photokina. So I'm proud about that. What I remember that I did with this photo was to crop it a bit. I would like to crop out this part and this part because, yeah, I want the focus to be more on this part of the photo. But I would like to keep this because it gives a bit of depth. This photo is taken with the wide angle, super wide angle macro lens, 15mm f4 from Venus Optics. A really cool lens. I did a video about it. Anyways, yeah, we need to increase the exposure a bit, like this. And then I would like the saturation to be... No, not the saturation. Maybe I just want to increase the greens by themselves. Let's try that. I would like the greens to look greener. I'm not sure. Yeah, that does a little, but not enough. Mm. I'm increasing the whites a bit because it always gives a little bit fresher look. Also increasing the shadows a bit to, I want this like really light feeling in this photo, which, because we have this like almost overexposed here. Now I'm bringing down the highlights a bit so that we can see more detail in these in the background. And I'm also bringing down the blacks a little bit so that the blacks on this, I don't know in the English word for it. This insect, like that. And this is a photo where I think we could benefit from some dark vignetting. Just a little bit like that. And maybe we should make it a little bit brighter still, like that. I'm still not super happy about the greens. I want the greens to be greener. That didn't do much. Yeah, maybe we need to leave it like this. Adjusted the luminance and the saturation a bit. And yeah, I must say I'm happy with this shot. Actually, the greens look a little bit unnatural now. I think I actually will just reset them to hide how they were. Yeah, this has to be it. Let's see what we can do with... No, I don't want to fiddle too much with the color of this insect here. I'm happy with this. Let's leave it like that. If we summarize these first five photos that I've done now, one technique that I work a lot with is vignetting. If it is a very bright and light photo, I like to add a slight hint of white vignette. And if it is a photo with dark edges of any kind, or like just, yeah, darker than average edges, it's nice to add a little bit of dark vignetting. I mean, everyone's taste is different, but I personally really like some vignetting. So here we have a snapshot of my wife Jenny, a photo that I kind of like. So let's see what we can do about it. First thing I'm thinking about is that this thing draws your eyes too quickly and too much. So let's do something about that. We could either crop it away like this, which I think is what I'm gonna do, or we could have used some clone stamp or something, but yeah, I'm lazy, so let's do it like this. And then obviously I think we want this photo to be a bit brighter because it was underexposed. This is nice. Now we see some more detail in the hair. And let's also try lifting the shadows a bit more, maybe like that, so that the hair is still dark but that you see more details. And the white t-shirt is looking a little bit gray, so let's try to lift the whites as well, but not so much so that you lose detail, maybe like this. And now I'm already very happy with this photo. It's a little bit cool with this edge, but maybe we can try to decrease the highlights a bit so that we actually can see some structure here. So we see that it is a wall and not some random white thing. And I actually like how we have a wall here as well that is a bit darker. So it kind of gives a bit, and also this shelf here, it gives a little bit of structure and to the image, and a little bit of depth to the image. I'm already pretty happy here. And I don't, in this case, I don't want to add a vignette because I think it would hurt the feeling of depth that we have here with these layers of stuff. So yeah, I think I'm just gonna leave it here. I think it looks good. And I think also the white balance was good from the beginning, but let's try the picker anyway. Yeah, now maybe it's possibly even better, but I'm not sure. Let's try the picker here as well. Yeah, and I think in this case, the white balance is a little bit of a matter of a taste. I think this was taken in the evening with quite yellow light. So this is probably closer to the truth of how the scene actually looked when I took the photo. I think actually I like the photo with a little bit more to the blue, like here somewhere. So I think I'm gonna go with this. So next shot. Yeah, as very often with my photos, it's a bit underexposed. Let's heighten it a bit. And I want to crop out a bit here. There are a lot of things going on in this photo, and I want to limit the amount of things you have to look at so that we get a little bit of focus. I want the focus to be on Max looking at Jenny and maybe on the flowers a bit and the stuff that they're working on here on the table. So let's try to crop out this part. And when I crop around a character like this, I try in when it's possible to have the same distance from this end as on this end. Here the hair goes like almost to the edge, so there is not much we can do there. So I'm gonna crop here pretty close to the edge so we will have some kind of visual balance here. And then I'm gonna crop until the edge of the flowers. So to make the picture feel more coherent, I'm keeping a short distance here because we have a short distance here, and that is because we have a short distance here. So if we would have had more distance here, I would probably have had more distance here and here as well. And on the other side, I think we will crop until the, like, almost at the edge of this tape roll here. Let's see how this looks. I'm pretty happy with it. I think it looks all right, but I think actually I want to leave a little bit more space here, here, and here. I don't like when things are too close to the edge. This I think looks a bit more harmonic, and then we will have to live with this. So let's look at the white balance. Let's do the picker here. Yeah, now it's a bit more correct. Let's lift the shadows a bit so we get more detail. And I think we in this photo we have a lot of white stuff, and the whites are though looking pretty gray. So in that case, it's always a good thing to increase the whites to make the picture a lot brighter, basically. This looks good. And yeah, I'm pretty happy with the photo now. I'm gonna try actually a dark vignette to see what happens. Gives a bit of a more cozy feeling. I'm also gonna see what I can do about colors on these flowers. No, I don't want to change them too much. Maybe I gave them a bit of a redder hue. Let's try this. I think it's pretty good as it is. I'm happy with this photo. Let's move on. Here we have another shot, I think from the same day. All right, you guys, I just noticed that we have so far just edited 7 photos, but we're already past the 20 minute mark. And from experience, I know that people on YouTube do not want to watch really, really long videos. So let's hold it here for now. And if you did like this video, please ask me in the comments to make more of these videos, and I will continue editing the rest of these photos and perhaps even some more photos. So if you like this and want more of this, I'm happy to do some more editing with you guys. So people on YouTube don't like long videos, but what people on YouTube do like is lists. And actually I've noticed that to get anyone to watch my videos, I basically have to name them top 5 ways of this and that, or top 10 tips for la la la. So for this video, I'm actually gonna name it my top 10 best Lightroom tips. And to summarize what we have talked about so far in this video, my 5 best tips, I think, is first of all, white balance. Learn about white balance and practice getting it right. It will do a big difference, and it will make the difference between a beginner and a pro, I would say. If you get the white balance wrong, that is a very clear indicator that you are not a pro. Number 2, use vignetting in creative and good ways. For a darker image, it often works well with a dark vignette, and for a bright image, use a white vignette, and you might make the image even brighter and make it look stronger. Number three, for almost any photo, it usually works very well to lift the shadows a bit and to dampen the highlights a bit to bring out more details basically in all parts of the photo. There are of course a lot of counterexamples here. In some cases you want a silhouette, for example, and then it might hurt the photo to lift the shadows. So you have to use your brain as always. Number four, fine tune the key colors of the photo. Even though natural colors are always nice, in some cases it can be really nice to change the colors just a little bit. Don't make them look unnatural, but make them look more interesting. That's my philosophy here. And in macro photo, often it's very hard to tell if a color is natural or not, because macro photos is like a world of its own. So here you might even allow yourself to tune the colors a bit more than in normal photography. And number five, if a photo feels a bit boring, a bit dull, you want to make it pop a bit more, draw up the whites. It very often makes the photo a lot more poppy, or whatever the word is, and a lot more interesting. So that's always something that could be good to try. Alright, that's it for this video. As I said, if you want more of this, comment down below, and if a lot of you comment that you want more of these videos, I will make more of them. I like doing them and they are quite easy to make, so why not? And please give me a like, a thumbs up if you did like this video, it helps this channel a lot, and see you soon again, over and out. And yeah, guys, before I forget to mention it, go into mwroll.com. Which is the place where you can sign up for my new newsletter. I have a newsletter, I just published the first edition of it, and if you sign up on mwroll.com, you will be on the list and you will get my newsletter every month. It will be all about photography with a focus on macro photography, and I will talk about all the things that I didn't have time or resources to bring up in my YouTube videos for the month. So it's about gear, it's about inspiration, it's about photos that I like, and yeah, it's about photography in general. Sign up for my newsletter, it's only once a month, and yeah, that's it for now. See you soon again in my next video or in my newsletter. Over and out, bye, thanks for watching.